Welcome to Math 30S Supplied, Week 5. It's mostly systems of linear equations. We're going to start some personal finance units too, how your paycheck works and deductions and stuff like that. Okay, so this is straight out of the notes. Just check this out. This is your cow and beaver notes. It's animated a little more nicely on my website. You can always pause this. Just touch the screen and pause it if you're looking on YouTube on this. So here we're explaining the elimination method now. I had demonstrated it a little while ago. Now we're just going to go nuts on it. The elimination method. We've learned how to graph to solve two equations with two unknowns. We've learned how to substitute to solve two equations with two unknowns. Now we're going to learn how to officially eliminate. So say you got two equations like that. The elimination method says, well, you can follow the steps in your reference notes. So I'm going to take equation one and leave it alone. I'm just going to rewrite it. I don't like to mess around with the original questions because then you can lose yourself. So just rewrite that equation one. Now I'm going to take equation two and I'm going to double it. So I'm going to go two times. No, I didn't mean to put an X. Let's make that like an asterisk there. That's better. I'm going to take two times equation two. And you're going, well, why would you do that? Well, just do it. So equation two now becomes twice as loud. 4X minus 2Ys equals 8. But notice when I add the two equations together, you can add the entire equations. Notice how the 2y and the negative 2y cancel each other out, so you're left with 8x is equals 24. Now you know that x is 3, so you take that 3, just like the other methods, you plug it back in to find out what the remaining unknown is. So that's just like in the substitution method. Now, once you figure out one of the variables, you plug it back into either original equation. Same last couple steps. And of course, you should always check your answer. Here it comes. Our 4 3s plus 2 2s equal to 16. Yep, give yourself a little happy face there. Our 2 3s minus 2 equal to 4. Let's think about this. Do we get a happy face? Here it comes. There we go. It works. Now, sometimes you have to eliminate. Now, you can slow this down. Sometimes you have to eliminate. Sometimes you have to multiply both equations by something. Both equations by something. Sometimes it's not so simple to see what to eliminate. So here's that example here that I just gave you there in your notes. Two equations, two unknowns. That's good. We're going to use the elimination method. Now notice that I can't really multiply one of the equations by something, so something in the other equation will cancel if I add or subtract them. You know, I could multiply it by something weird like 1.5. If I multiplied the top equation by 1.5, that would turn that 2y into 3y's, and then they'd cancel if I subtracted. But let's not go into 1.5's. So let's do something else. Watch what happens here. I'm going to take equation number one, and I'm going to, what am I going to do to it? I'm going to multiply it by 3. And you're going, why? Well, just watch. I'm going to triple equation number one. And it doesn't quite come out right there. I had to obviously erase something there. And I'm going to take, there it goes. And I'm going to take equation two, and I'm going to double it. And notice what happens here. That's up to you what you want to do. So I tripled equation 1, I doubled equation 2, then I'm subtracting equation 2 from equation 1. Notice how the y's disappear. And you're left with 11x's equals, sounds like about a positive 11 to me. 9 take away a negative 2 is positive 11. Oh yeah, you gotta know that taking away a negative is adding. Taking away some bad stuff is actually good. Anyway, then the final same steps as substitution. Once you calculate the one unknown, you plug it back into either original equation. There you go. There's the solution. An x of 1 and a y of negative 1. Let's do it this time, but I'll eliminate the x. Last time we eliminated the y. This time I'll double equation 1 and quintuple equation 2. Look how the x's will disappear now. And there's those subtracting negative things again. This time we found out the y first. The y is negative 1. Then we plug the negative 1 in to either original equation to find out that the x is, son of a gun, it better be the same as the last time we just did it in the previous slide. It's 1. Okay, and here's assignment Charlie 3. Solve by elimination. Follow the steps in your reference notes. Look how this one was set up really nice. I just lined them up. I put them in a standard order. Like by standard, I don't mean any particular one standard, but put them in the same order so they line up so you can see what you could cancel. So notice that I got y equals some crap and y equals some crap. By subtracting them, the y's will disappear. But that means that y minus y is 0, and then people get confused. Like, well, gee, that means that 9, right? 0 equals 3x minus 9. How do you solve that? Well, you follow the same steps. You add 9 to both sides. Now you got 9 equals 3x, and then you get 3 equals x. This is another one of those occasions where people see 0 and don't know what to do. Just follow your steps. Get that x by itself. 0 is a perfectly legal number. So now we found out that x is 3. Now guess what we do with it now? We take that x and we plug it back into either original equation. Just like in the substitution method. Here it comes. Let's plug it into equation 1. That looks easy, because 3 minus 4 is negative 1. And watch those integers. We still have folks getting excited about this stuff. Right? If I take 5 marks off of your test, right? Take away 1, take away 2, take away 1, take away... If I take 5 marks off of your test, and then you come to me later and say, Mr. F, but I did the question right, can you take away one of the takeaways? Well, if you had negative 5 and I take away one of the negative 1s, doesn't that mean the same as I gave you back 1 mark on your test? So now instead of losing 5 marks, you're going to only lose 4 marks. So you're going to have 36 out of 40 on your test. There's one way to explain that subtracting a negative is the same as adding. If I take away something bad, most people consider that to be good. And negatives are usually bad. So let's do the elimination method here. Look how the y's will easily cancel. I'm just going to take equation 1 and subtract equation 2, or you could do equation 2, subtract equation 1 if you're fussy. Just watch those negative negatives. Some websites will show you to multiply by a negative number, so you always get to add. But adding a negative is the same as subtracting. That's kind of goofy. Let's do more elimination here. I'm going to take equation 1 and I'm going to add 2 equation 2's. Notice how by adding the x's disappear. I think we're all pretty solid on this now. You know, we said we'd have a test on this very soon. You've actually got a practice test for this stuff. Now we start to get into some word problems. Two numbers add to make 26, but their difference is 16. What are the two numbers? And I did it by elimination. There's two ways. The first time I eliminated the B, the second time I eliminated the A. The first time I added them together to get rid of the B, the second time I subtracted them to get rid of the A. You still end up with the same answers. It works every time. It's been working for a couple thousand years for us. And here's bits and pieces of the assignment we did, Charlie 4. Now some of your assignments and websites will call it the addition and subtraction method. I just call it the elimination method, because you're going to add or subtract to eliminate things. So some teachers call it different things. You're adding or subtracting to eliminate. See, that one was pretty easy. You could instantly just add the two equations and the y disappears. Or you could have graphed them. Or you could have done substitution. There's other ways too. Matrices. In grade 12 you'll learn matrices. This one had a little trick to it because they weren't in the same order. You couldn't see exactly what would cancel what. So you had to rearrange one of the equations so the x's lined up with the y's and the constants lined up with, correction, the x's lined up with the x's and the y's lined up with the y's and the constants lined up with the constants. Otherwise it'll be hard to see what could add or subtract to cancel something out. Look, when you rearrange them in a nice order, I tend to put x's before y's. Sort of an alphabetical thing, and most mathematicians do that. When you put them in a nice organized order to compare them, look how the y's will disappear if you add them together. So your x ends up being 3, and as before, you take that 3 and you plug it back into either of the original equations, blah blah blah. You should always check your answers. Right, so the first one checked. An x of 3 and a y of 6. Let's check the next one. Is 5 3's the same as 2 6's plus 3? Let's see. 5 3's is 15. 2 6's is 12 plus 3. Yeah, the left side is 15. The right side is 15 in equation 2. So another happy face. Lots of smiles. Okay, how are we doing? Oh, I love these word problems. These are crazy. I don't like the mixture ones, though. Those are kind of, yeah. I need to practice those myself. Anyway, I gave you a whole hockey sock full of word problems in case you wanted to have some fun. Okay, so there was the problem. 6 years ago, Bob was 4 times as old as Mary. In 4 years, he will only be twice as old as Mary. How old are they now? So what is the question? What are you looking for? You are looking for how old are they now? It says right there. So let's give those names. Let's pretend that B is Bob's age now, unless you want to write Bob's age now all the time. Let's pretend that M, for Mary, is Mary's age now. If you want to use X's and Y's, that's fine, but then makes more sense to use B for Bob and M for Mary. Okay, now we've given a secret little code for the two things that we're looking for. Now we know we've got two equations, so we know we got two unknowns, rather, so we know we need two equations. Well, doesn't the first sentence there say that 6 years ago, Bob, well, if Bob is B right now, 6 years ago, wasn't he B minus 6? Whatever today is, minus 6, yeah. And he was. The word was means equals. It means is, but in the past. So he was equals 4 times as old as Mary. Well, as old as Mary was then. So 4 times as old as Mary was 6 years ago. Well, Mary is M now, so take away 6. So M minus 6 is how old Mary was 6 years ago. So there's the first equation. B minus 6 equals 4 bunches of M minus 6. Then the second sentence says, in 4 years. Well, if he's B right now, how old is he going to be in 4 years? Well, he'll be B plus 4, the unknown amount plus 4. And he'll be, he will means equals, be twice as old. So Mary in 4 years will be M plus 4. So two M plus 4s. So let's tidy up equation 1 a little bit there so, you know, we don't have all these constants all over the place. Let's tidy it up into more the form of a line like we're familiar with. Let's tidy up equation 2 so it's more like in a linear line form. Let's take equation 1 and subtract equation 2. Turns out that Mary is 11 now. So if Mary is 11 now, sounds to me like B is 26. It's pretty intense, eh? So Mary is 20, or correction, Bob is 26, Mary is 11. And you can check those numbers, you know, by rereading the sentences and plugging them in. And it works. And here's another example from the assignment. That one's pretty simple. Always do the checking at the end. Make sure you get the little happy smile there. This one's all set up for a pretty simple elimination method. You could do other methods if you want, but this one's set up kind of nice for getting rid of the Y, finding the X, taking that X, plugging it back into either original equation to find the Y. Sounds to me like the solution is X equals 5, Y equals 4. 5 comma 4. I hope you're familiar with this section of your reference notes. You're allowed to use this on tests. If you want to add extra bits to it or examples, go for it. I think we've pretty much put this beast to bed. I have to give you some more challenging stuff. This is too easy for you. Don't forget those negative negatives. Taking away a negative is adding. See when I did the check in line 1 there? 2 1's minus a negative 2. It really is 4. It works because that's 2 minus a negative 2. 2 taking away a negative 2 is the same as 2 plus 2. Taking away a negative is adding. If I take away something bad in your life, didn't I just add to your life? Right? You may still have a negative life, but it's not as negative as it used to be. Let's try this one. Oh, we're doing the same question, but now we're doing it by substitution. Because all the methods work. See, I'm dividing by a negative 5. That's 10 divided by negative 5, not just 10 divided by 5. Once you get the Y, you plug it back into either original equation. There's more of those negative negatives again. Well, it's the same negative negatives. You get the same answer, which is good. Oh, I asked you to do elimination here. So I doubled equation 1, and I just left equation 2 alone. And when I subtract the two results there, the x disappears. You could do something else if you wanted. You could triple equation 1 and quintuple equation 2 and add them together. Or you could have multiplied the top equation by 3/5, because that would turn the 5 into 3. But don't go multiplying by fractions. There's about 8 different ways to do this if you were so inclined. Usually go for the simple method. Let's do the same problem by substitution. We already know the answer is 2.5, comma, negative 1. So I isolate the x in equation 1. I could have isolated the y. I could have isolated variables in equation 2. I just randomly picked isolate the x in equation 1. So now x is 5 plus 5y's divided by 2. So wherever I see a x now in the other equation, in the second equation, I plug in 5 plus 5y's divided by 2. Grouping those like terms, doing a little bit of basic algebra, I think we're going to get the same answer. I sure hope so. Plugging that negative 1 back in to find the x in either equation tells me that it's 2.5. Gives you the same answer. Two different methods, same answer. Let's do it by graphing. Notice these are in that general form, or the intercept form, of lines. You did lines back in grade 10. And my favorite way of doing lines to find the intercepts is I just pretend that the x is 0 and the y is 0. So if the x is 0, cover up the 2x with your thumb. So negative 5 times something equals 10. Sounds to me like negative 5 times, you know, if you divide both sides by, looks like I might have messed up there. Negative 5 times, yeah, y is negative 2. Yeah. I should have divided both sides by negative 5. I only showed you that I divided by 5, right? But I still got the right intercept there, right? And when the y is 0, the x is obviously 5. We'll cover up the negative 5 y's. Right, now we're in the black there. So when the x is 0, what is the y? And when the y is 0, what is the x? Well, when the x is 0, looks like 3y's will be 7. Now, people get confused. Well, if 3y's equals 7, there is no answer. Well, of course there's an answer. You divide by 3. It's called 7/3, or 1, and correction, 2 and 1/3. Sad to tell you this, but fractions are perfectly legal numbers. The answer is 7/3. All right, so when the x is 0, it's 7/3, or 2 and 1/3, if you like those kind of fractions. I don't, but go for it. When the y is 0, what is the x? Well, cover up the 3 y's. Looks like x is 7/4. Well, that'd be 1 3/4 to a carpenter. So when you graph those points, and then somebody here shortly asked me, well, how do you graph 1 3/4, and how do you graph 2 1/3? So I'll show you how to graph them here in a second. Anyway, you'll see that they do cross at, even with my big broad pencil here on the board, it looks like 2.5, negative 1 to me. Right, so here's where I'm explaining how to graph 7/3, or how to graph 1 2/3, etc., or 2 1/3 rather. All right, so I'm just going to show you a number line here. And if you want to graph 7/3, which we call 2 1/3, right, we're going to graph 7/3, which some people call 2 1/3. All right, I'm going to take between 2 and 3, I'm going to picture it broken into 3 parts. So I'm going to break it into 3 parts, and I'm going to take one of those parts, because that's 1 part out of 3. So there's 2 1/3, the black dot. What's 1 3/4? Well, I'm picturing between 1 and 2, I'm picturing that broken into 4 parts, and I'm going to take 3 out of the 4 parts. So that's 1 3/4. So yeah, doing this on graph paper is kind of tough, because you got to start picturing in your head. So you won't get the exact right answer when you're graphing things, especially in real problems. But you should be able to eyeball what 1 2/3 is, for example, on a line. Now we do the exact same problem, but this time on your TI-83 graphing calculator. Or there's lots of websites that do graphing things on them too. Right, now your graphing calculator, of course, I mean, it's just a stupid computer. It only knows how to evaluate stuff. All right, so it wants to know what is y. So you got to tell it that y is negative 2 plus 2 fifths of an x. Because it doesn't understand how to calculate things when the x's and the y's are on the same side. So you got to tell it how to calculate the y. So everything else has to go off to the right. Computers are actually kind of stupid. But they can do a lot of stupid things real quick. And, okay, we won't mention names here. But anyway, there's what it'll look like on your graphing calculator if you can't sort of see it in your head. Don't forget to go zoom number 6 standard, second trace calculate, 5 intersect, where they cross, give it. Just hit enter 3 times. There's only one answer. Let's solve a couple more. This was on the assignment as well. One of the assignments, I forget which one. Let's solve it by elimination. Standard order, find the y. Plug it back into either equation. There's the solution, 3, 2. Do it by substitution. Sounds like we'll have to isolate something. Makes sense to isolate the y, because it's got a positive 1. Or if you see that y, plug that into the first equation. Well, isn't that fun how it gets the same answer? You gotta love it when you get the same answer twice. Getting the same answer doing two different methods is usually encouraging. Okay, I'm going to have to get out and get the lawn cut here. The sun's just come out again. Oh, now this one's mean, all right? But hey, you should be able to handle fractions. So I said let's try this by elimination. Now, there's a bunch of fractions in here. 2/3 of a jar of pickles plus 1/5 of a box of Raisin Bran costs $6. So if 1/6 of a jar of pickles minus the price of 1/2 a box of Raisin Bran is equal to negative $4, then how much does each cost? There you go. You could turn this into a word problem if you wanted. The secret to doing this is to multiply by the lowest common denominator, the LCD. That will get rid of all the fractions. All right, you're just going to make the first one 15 times louder. You're going to multiply everything by 15. Look what happens here. Isn't that a little nicer? You don't have all those crazy numbers. Let's take equation 2 and multiply it by the lowest common denominator. Well, what number does 2 go into that 6 also goes into? Well, 2 goes into 6 already. And 6, of course, goes into itself once. So let's multiply both sides of the equation, the entire sides, by 6. And you end up with that new equation too. Aren't those a little smarter? Oh, and look how they're going to magically cancel out. Oh, you got to love that. Look how on the right there, how the y's are already going to cancel out. You don't have to muck about with them or anything. Oh, sweet. There you go. 11x is equal 66. Sounds like x is 11. Sounds like you take that 11, or correction, 6. Sounds like you take that 6, plug it back into either equation. And you should plug it into the original equations. Don't go cheating and plug it into one of the ones that you tweaked up and got rid of the denominators. Technically, you should plug it into the original equation. So I'm plugging it back into equation number 1, just for no particular reason. Is 12/3, so it turns out that 12/3 plus y over 5 is 6. So that means 4 plus 1/5 of a y is 6. Which means, if I carry that on, that means y over 5 has to be, let's see, taking away 4 off both sides is 10. Is 2, rather. So, multiplying by 5, y is 10. All right, and I show you, right now I'm just showing you how I got 10, because a lot of people didn't understand that y divided by 5 equals 2. means that if you multiply both sides by 5, that'll tell you what a whole y is. If a fifth of a y is 2, then a whole 1y has to be 5 times as many. And let's do it again, but this time I was going to solve now by substitution. Oh, this gets ugly. Just watch this noise. You probably don't want to do it this way. You want to be a little bit good at fractions to be doing this. But I gave out a huge fraction package to those who wanted to practice it. And I did Joe's method there. I multiplied everything by 60 so that it would turn out to nice round numbers later on, right here. It's pretty hard to mess up algebra. As long as you do the same thing to both sides of an equation, even if you make a wrong step, as long as you make the wrong step to both sides, you can't possibly screw up algebra. So don't be afraid. Almost to the end here. I think we've done a lot of these, and I think you can see a challenge with this one right away. Well, I sort of gave you the hint there in the diagram. It's really the same equation said twice. Equation 1 and equation 2 are saying the same thing. Equation 2 is just saying it twice as loud. Right? I tried to fool you there by exchanging the position of the x's and y's, but if you look at it, you'd notice that equation 2 is really saying exactly the same as equation 1. It's just twice as loud. So when you try to do the math, you'll end up with 0 equals 0. And you go, huh? Well, that's because it's a dependent solution. That means you didn't have enough different equations. So you've actually got an infinite number of correct answers. Every little purple dot on there is an answer. So how can you be wrong if there's an infinite number of correct answers? Well, except there's an infinite number of wrong answers. I've got a book on infinity that my daughter bought me. Oh, it is crazy. It's taken me 2 summers to read it. I'm still not done. Understanding infinity is pretty interesting. All right, try these types of problems here. The first of 2 numbers is added to twice the second. Let's give the numbers names. A is the first number, B is the second. It's easier. So read the first sentence, because we're looking for 2 numbers. So we gave them names. So A, that's the first of 2 numbers, is added. So adding. Adding means, well, that means plus, twice the second. Oh, that means 2 times the second. That's what twice means. The result is, the word is means equals. All right? When you say something is something, then it means equals. Now the second sentence, will that tell us something? But when the second number... Alright, so there we go. Now the second number, which we're calling B, is added. Alright, well the is, yeah, that is doesn't mean equals there, the is later. The second number's added, so there's going to be a plus sign in there to twice the first number. So B plus 2 times, now the first number is A, so it'll be B plus 2 A's. The result is, well, the word is means equals, 18. Find the 2 numbers. Well, there you go. Sounds to me like you got a system of 2 linear equations, 2 equations, and they happen to be lines, by the way. You can actually do these methods without lines. I'll show you that later. You can do them with parabolas. Ooh, and cortex and things. All right, but let's just do these lines. Of course, the standard steps are to get them lined up. Okay, so they're lined up over top of each other. I can see what to do now. I'm going to take equation 2 and double it. So that'll give me 4 A's plus 2 B's. Okay, so I'm doubling the entire equation. That's going to be 36. So I've done that. So if I take away 2 equation 2's from equation 1, that will make the b's disappear. So I'm going to have negative 3a's equals negative 15, dividing by negative 3 on both sides. Sounds to me like a is 5. Now you take that 5, you plug it back into either one of the original equations. Let's just do the first one, that's easiest. 5 plus 2 somethings equals 21. 5 plus 2 somethings equals 21. Sounds like about 8 to me. And you should always check your answers if you get a chance. And a couple little happy faces there. And off we go to the next problem. So 5 T's and 8 chairs, so I'm going to call that 8 C's, cost. So the cost is, this is sort of like a hidden is in there, 115. 3 tables, so 3 T's, well, 3 times the price of a table, and 5 times the price of a chair is a cost of 70. And they don't put the word is in there, but determine the cost of both. All right, there we go. I'm going to take equation 1 and triple it, and I'm going to take equation 2 and quintuple it, and then T's will magically disappear if I subtract them. Or I didn't have to do that. I could have taken 8 times equation 1 and 5 times equation 1 and 8 times equation 2, and that would have canceled out the C's. So, depends on what you want to cancel out first. You get the same answers, alright? So on the left there, I canceled out the T's first. So of course, then you got to go back in to calculate the T. On the right, I canceled out the C's first. But notice you're getting the same answers, alright? So whatever you decide to multiply and your equations by to eliminate one of them, it doesn't really matter. You'll still end up with the same answers. So I did 2 different eliminations there. See if you can follow this. If D is your dad's, is a dad's age, then D minus 2 is his age 2 years ago. And the first sentence says that 2 years ago he was 6 times as old as his boy, is now. So B minus 2 is how old the boy was 2 years ago. So 6 times B minus, so there's equation 1 taken care of. Let's look at the second sentence. In 18 years you'll be 18 more than your D, because D is the present age. And in 18 years the dad will be 2 times the age of the boy's age now. So the boy's age now is B, so in 18 years it would be B plus 18, double that. There you go. So you now have 2 equations, tidy them up a little bit so you can manipulate them a little easier. Combine the constants in there, tidy it up so it looks a little bit more like a line. There you go. I'm just going to take equation 1 and subtract equation 2. The D's will disappear. And you may not like having 4b minus 28 equals 0, but it's actually pretty simple to solve. People get confused what to do with a 0. So the dad is 32 right now, and the boy is 7. You can check that if you want. The dad is 32 and the boy is 7, because 2 years from now, 2 years ago, the dad would have been 30 and the boy would have been 5. So that works. And here's the last problem. We never did get a chance to solve this, but if you want to solve this on your lonesome, it turns out the answer is that the man's paddling speed is 3 and the current speed is 1.5. That's the answer to this one. And that completes the notes for week 5. I hope these are helping you. Thank you.